My name is Anton Zotin. I'm from Germany, but was born in Russia, in Siberia. I'm working in a hair company. It's a part of Nokia company. And today we will try to figure out, based on our real experience, how Kanban works. And I want to make a comment that this workshop will be extremely hands-on experience. So please be prepared to be very active. I think that's a good time after lunch not to fall into the food coma. And what also I want you to do, please come a little bit closer. You need to occupy 8 tables because we will have 8 workstations. I don't know. Please self-organize. So I need 8 tables full of people. That's first. Second, I want to give you advice. Please clean your tables as much as possible because everything that's now on your tables will be your waste and it will limit your speed. How much you will be able to get? So 8 tables. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Wonderful. Okay. Please clean your tables. If you do not clean your tables, you will have some problems. Okay. Number one. Number two. Does any table need multi-members? Because maybe you will want to rearrange your resources. Yes, maybe you need more, or maybe you want to fire someone from your table. Okay, good. So what we are gonna to do today? Today we will run a special business. We are 8 companies that are producing animals from Lego. Inside your boxes, there are your resources that we will use. I think you know that resources are quite pricey, so use them wisely. On the other hand, you know that you are 8 companies and 8 competitors, and you need to work really fast. So what you're going to do? That's very simple. First, you need to define at every table one customer. This customer will accept work. So just for 1 minute, please, very quickly, define. If you found a customer, raise the hand. Got. One customer. Got. You have a customer? Yeah. Awesome. Only one customer per table. Don't try. I know that you would like to be a customer, all of you. But sorry, only one customer. Okay, so how you will work? That's very simple. The first step now is a top secret step. We'll find out what is it about a little bit after some time. So these are instructions for every team. These animals we are going to build. Please spend some time to investigate what is this animal. So what we're going to do? We're going first to build an animal as fast as possible and as much as possible. Second, build animal doesn't mean that it's ready. It should be colored. And you will have a special color stations. One for each team. These stations are very, very pricey. Because of that, you have only one. So all money. And yes, of course, don't cheat with Lego, because I already see that some teams started to sort them. Because if any Lego left the box, that's a bought resource, okay? So if Lego inside of the box, that's a market of these resources. If any piece left the box, sorry, you spent your money. Okay, good. How we are gonna to color down animals? That's also very simple. Colorful station has several rules. First, it can color at the same time no more than three animals. So you put three or less animals, done animals, onto this coloring station and check by the timer for at least 30 seconds. So if animal stood on the station less than 30 seconds, sorry, it's broken. It could be stand more. Also, coloring station, when it started to work, it's closed. So you define when it starts to work. After that, you are not able to put any more animals. You wait until the coloring process will finish. Okay? What next? Next, after your animal is built and colored, you need to put an individual serial number. Well, we are a strong business. We need to put a serial numbers to competitor to with China developers. Because we want to make a strong trademark, you know? How to put a serial number? You have this tape. You put this tape on the animal and put 8 digits individual serial number. It will help to prevent any China duplicates. Also, to be sure that any animal was built inside of your team, you need to put this serial number into a special serial number journal. You could use any piece of paper. Please join any team. Okay, so after animal is built, after it's colored, after it's got an individual serial number, and this individual serial number was put into the serial number journal, you are able to give this animal to your customer. How customer is going to check if it's okay or not? So, rules for customers. First, check color pattern. That's important. So if you see that some pieces of animals on the photo are different, they should be different. But also, it could be any other colors. So if you see that on the photo, only black and white colors, you could use, for example, green and yellow. Okay? Also, customers, check the shape. So pieces, bricks, could be different. So for example, it could be not something like a big part, but a number of small parts. But the final shape should be the same as on the photo. Okay? Any questions? Good. Good. So, how we are going to run this? We'll run this in iterations. To identify that iteration started, you will hear this signal. Okay? That's the start. Also, if you hear it again, that's the finish. When you got a finish of iteration, please raise your hands and do nothing with what's happening on the table. Because we are here not, well, not to game really in a rush and not to cheat. We are here to learn. If we will cheat and rush, we will learn nothing. Okay? So, yes. No, customer, well, that's the customer. Customer can't be involved in the process of development.
And not accepted.
Okay, any other questions?
Iteration duration is asking. 5 minutes?
5 minutes, yes. Okay, so let's start do it the first time. Go. Or not accept.
Individual person will create
guys.
One animal.
Check, you are able, believe me. Raise your hands. Okay, several comments before we will do something. First, I made an observation. Customers, these observations for you also. First, I've seen that different teams started to build different ships with a different size. That's wrong. So the shape as in picture should be the same. So you can't build a ship like this size. Only the size that is described on the picture. That's first. Second, I've observed that some teams started to use bricks of any color, so like their ships looks like hipsters or hippie. So for example, 5 colors in one ship or 10 colors in one ship. Only 2 colors, as it described also on the picture. Third, I've seen that some teams started to color a lot of animals on the coloring station. I don't know how, because this station can't color more than 3 animals at once. Okay? After these comments, customers, honestly, make a final acceptance on the table right now for 10 seconds. Okay. So, what I want you to do now, every team will get such paper, and this paper you should put number of round, so this is the first round, number of animals that were accepted, number of animals that were not accepted, and number of bricks that are on the table right now, so that were put out from the box and that were not used. So if you have, for example, ship that is built but not colored, that's also number of bricks, because that's not a delivered value. That's something in progress. So calculate all bricks that are in progress, just from the box, just a part of the ship, or just ship that is coloring right now.
Come back here for next iteration?
No. Right now, we're just calculating.
Okay, what we should do with this?
This is accepted.
For next iteration?
This is accepted?
Yeah.
Let me check. It looks like it's not accepted.
No?
Yeah, because you see, it's not so tall.
But our customer is happy.
Hang on, sorry, tell me again.
It's not this, it's not so tall as that. It should be like this. So this is the right. Okay? Okay. Yes, yes, of course.
So the ones that weren't colored, do they carry over or?
So if they are colored,
they didn't go through coloring.
So just calculate. This is bricks. Yep. They're in progress. Any questions?
Yeah. So look at our shapes. All are same.
Yes, everything is okay.
Excellent.
Yep. I've just accepted two, rejected one because one serial number was only 6 digits.
Okay. Okay. Good. Good. So
that they can rework, right, in the next iteration.
What?
They can rework on this in the next iteration.
I will explain it later.
See, I have a question.
Yes.
So, this brick is long, so shall I consider it two bricks or one brick?
It's one brick.
One brick.
Yes,
okay.
Yes. Any questions? No, okay. Any questions?
So these are not accepted, so this will be considered as individual bricks. We have to go.
Yes, yes,
so
yes.
Seven,
yes. Yeah.
So putting the serial number also part of 5 minutes?
Yes, of course. Of course, that's a part of the process. Any questions? Yes, that's a waste. That's still in progress. So calculate the number of bricks. Okay. Any questions?
What are the information we need to capture here?
Number. So the current number of round, number of accepted animals, and number of bricks that are on table. Don't put bricks inside of the box. Leave them on the table. Okay. Are you ready for the next round? Please raise your hands that you are ready. Please raise your hands to show me that you are ready. Okay, good. So what I want you to do now, you made some notes about how much animals you were able to build, how much bricks are in progress right now. So please quickly disassemble all animals and return all bricks to the box. To make our experiments crystal clear, not to mess it with the previous iteration. Raise your hands if you're ready. Awesome. So second round is going to start. You need to put it on the tape and tape on the animal and also enter the sums. What? Your hands. Okay. A very important comment. Now, please do not disassemble any animal and do not put all bricks into the box. Leave them on the table. Okay? So, what I want you to do now, as usual, calculate your results. Number of animals that were accepted, number of animals that were rejected, and number of bricks that are still in the progress. Okay? Let's go. Yes, this is in progress. Mm-hmm. So calculate number of bricks. So this. These are in progress, yes.
So these are in progress, so.
Yeah. Yeah, so number of bricks.
So you count both of them, right?
Sorry?
So we have count both of them.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. So raise your hands if you are done. Awesome, awesome. So, I want you to do now a little bit, don't think about what's happening on the table, because we are here not just to build funny animals from Lego bricks. We are here also to talk a little bit about Kanban, okay? and figure out, does it help or not? I don't know. Maybe it's not. So a very basic explanation of Kanban method. That's a very simple, really. So if you got a book by David Anderson, the essence of Kanban method, it's just 5 steps. And that's all. All other parts of this book, that's just philosophy, some ideas, some examples, some experiments. The core idea of Kanban is simple. First, visualize your workflow. So how it goes, really. So everyone will be able to see how it works. Second, limit work in progress. So define step that you visualize on the previous first version, and limit work in progress. So in your case, for example, it will be limiting number of bricks, or number of papers for serial numbers, or number of coloring. So you already have some physically limited work in progress, like number of animals on coloring station. That's second. Third is measure and manage flow. So you already measure your flow and understand its productivity. Manage flow, that's just to stick into this described workflow and do as it's as a drone. So go from step to step without any violating these steps. The fourth one is to make process policies explicit, so everyone will understand how these steps are doing. For example, these are one of these processes rules. Less or 3 animals at the coloring station, and more or equal to 30 seconds. So you also will have these rules for other steps. And fifth, it's use models to recognize improvements, opportunities. So if I explain in other words, just search how you are able to optimize the whole this workflow using different approaches like agile retrospectives, or maybe theory of constraints, or maybe some other techniques. Okay? How it looks really on the paper. This is a typical Kanban board. So first, this is a visualized workflow. You see steps. That's first. Second, limiting work in progress. You see that red numbers. So it's not possible to put more than 7 work items into this step. Third one, process policies. You see here I draw some bricks. For example, here are possible only bricks with this shape and with this shape. That's process policies. What else we have? Yes, measuring. We're already measuring it and searching for opportunities. I hope in a few iterations we will do this. So what I want you to do now, you have these tapes, sticky tapes. Please use it to draw your Kanban board. And you have some very interesting tip. Observe your table and see what bricks that are not done you see on your table. That somehow will explain you how your table will look like. Because we are not going to improve our process right now. We are just going to visualize it to find out how it works and then to improve. So observe which bricks do you see. Or just remember what was happening during the last iteration. Also think about limiting work in progress, making some policies implicit. So you got 5 minutes to visualize it. So just put these lines to visualize borders. In your case, you have round tables. Maybe you will have round-shaped Kanban board. That's not a problem. Okay? So 5 minutes. Assemble all of them. Yes, yes. You could use not a paper. You could use the entire table.
What if I want to make a 5 minutes for the study?
And then you will use it. The phases, how you work, how you build these animals. Yes.
what is the cost of the wasted bricks?
We're not thinking about it. So we know that it's pricey.
Yeah, but we're trying to work out from a process perspective whether or not we want to optimize for wasted bricks.
I understand. It's too complicated. Yes, yes, of course, of course. 3 minutes left. Oh, awesome, awesome. Raise your hands. Okay. So, what we are gonna to do now? First, disassemble all animals and move all undone bricks to the box. Disassemble all animals and return all bricks to the box. Okay.
So we created the workstations.
Yes. Yes.
We also have a Kanban board.
No. That's your Kanban board. Yes. Just put WIP limits, work in progress limits. Yes.
We need to keep a count at each point.
Yeah. Of course. Put work in progress limits. If you're ready, raise your hand. Okay. If you're ready, raise your hand. Okay. Two tables are not ready. Ready. Okay. So, what I want you to do now, absolutely the same. We are going. Guys. Raise your hands. Keep calm. Oh, good. So what I want you to do, the same. You are going to build animals. But now, please, follow the process you visualized. That's important. Use steps that now described in your board. And please also be very accurate with work in progress limits. So if you put, for example, at one step number 7, do not put into this step things more than 7, okay? Okay. Yes? Sorry?
Can you repeat that?
So, again, please, you haven't put work in progress limits. So please be careful with them and do not violate these rules, okay? Okay. So, raise your hands. Raise your hands. Raise your hands. And keep calm. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, go. One minute left. Your hands. Raise your hands. Okay. Small comment. I've made an observation that some teams at the finish of the round started to return bricks to the box. You understand, yeah? So that's definitely something like a cheating. If you got some resources, you bought them. That's all. And if at the end they are on the table, that's your waste. Because of that, we are trying to simulate this. Okay? So, quickly, calculate everything without returning to box. Just calculate number of done animals, number of not accepted, and number of bricks in the into the progress. When you will be ready, raise your hands. Are you ready? Yeah.
So there are two approaches. Tell us which one is good from your perspective. So one is person A picks up all the raw material to sell to person B who assembles it.
Well.
Or route two is the person one picks up only two pieces, they assemble it.
Okay. Quick tip. Also, I've made an observation that many teams decided to stick one person to one phase of the development. And I observed that some people really struggling putting a lot of parts together. And some just, okay, when it will be ready. So you see, you visualized not people. You visualized just your process. So feel free to collaborate together. So now you will have 3 minutes. Also, observe your tables to define what's happening in terms of done and not done work. And maybe correct your boards, correct your rules, and your work in progress limits. Just something like a retrospective about your process. 3 minutes. Go. To make it better. Now you are working at changing your process.
Right.
You're not assembling new animals. We are not working. We are discussing our process to optimize it.
Very little time.
No, this time is not given to start.
Yes, yes. This time is given to improve your process.
Yes, but we are not.
Not to work. Okay, raise your hands. Raise your hands. Okay, good. So, again, a short reminder. I've observed that a lot of teams started to build animals. But we were going not to build. So you see, what is Odd Agile about? For some time, we need to stop. You know? For some time in Agile, we need to stop to think about if we are moving to the right direction. If we will spend all our time just running, maybe we are running to hell, you see?
Can I ask a question?
Yes, of course.
To decide the work in progress limit.
Uh-huh.
Okay, this is fine because only three covering stations.
Okay.
Okay. But in real scenario, is it hit and trial basis or is there some concept behind it? How you identify different?
Just on the real experience. So you see what's happening, then you are changing it constantly. So, what we're going to do, we are going to run it again. But after this, remember, we will run a retrospective with 3 minutes. And you will not build animals. You will discuss your process. Because rule number 5, we need some time to recognize how to improve our process. Okay? So, please disassemble all animals and return all bricks into the boxes. If you are ready, raise your hands. Okay, this table is ready. This table is ready. This table is ready. This table is ready. This table. Ready, 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 ready. So, 1, 2, 3, go! Awesome, awesome. Again, do not return any brick and any animal. Just calculate your results. Let's go. Okay, who is ready? Raise your hands. Ready, 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 ready. Are you ready? Okay, awesome. Now, we're going to do resource replanning. How it's going to be. Every half of a table will change the table. So we will mix our teams, okay? So half of a table, stand up and move to another table. Okay? Let's go. Let's share our experience, our technology secrets. Go and grab someone. Raise your hands if your table is ready. Faster, faster. I believe you are able to self-organize. Thank you. So what I want you to do now, please, you will have 5 minutes not to work, okay? Not work, but to invest this time to share your experience with all your new team members, to observe the Kanban board, maybe to update it, maybe to draw a new one. You will have 5 minutes, okay? So let's go. Hands. Okay. If you have some animals or bricks on the table, disassemble them and put into the boxes. Then raise your hands again to show me that you are ready. So this table is ready. This table is ready. Ready. Near the ready state. Again, return all blocks into the table. Okay, let's start. Thank you. Awesome. Just a quick reminder. Do not disassemble animals. Do not return any bricks into boxes. Just calculate results. Okay? Let's go. Ready? Ready. Okay, so 3 minutes retrospective to improve your process. Go. Please also disassemble all animals and return all blocks into the box. Awesome. Calculate your results. Okay, when you got results, please hang them right there. So we already have one result there. Let's create some kind of a winner's wall with all results. Also, I will appreciate if you put all blocks again to the packet.
Do you have?
Okay. So we are running out of the time. Three last things I want you to do. First, this game called Business Cards Exchanging. So you go here from 5 to 1. That's a feedback door. Please put a sticker. If you think that's 5, that's an awesome workshop. 1, that's the worst time I spent ever. If you have some comments, put them also into the stickers. I will be able to improve this workshop. And the last one, please discuss with each other and this day and other days, what was happening here, what you could bring to your workplace, and just your ideas. And feel free to catch me and ask any questions. And thank you very much.